Hi, this is Jaya. In this video, we shall see the summary of Separating by John Updike. Come, let's go to the summary. The story begins with Richard Maple and Joan Maple planning for their divorce. And they feel that they have to inform to the four children about their divorce. And so they are waiting for the correct time to inform the children. And they together decide that the elder daughter Judith, who is 19 years old, is studying abroad in England. So they decide that after she comes back, they will break the news to all of them together. And Richard says that we will announce this news to them in the dinner table. But Joan tells, no, I think it's better we talk to each and every child separately and explain to them why we are separating. The reason why they are getting divorces, they feel that there is no love between them even after four children. So it is better to lead their own lives, their own way than to live together as husband and wife. And that night when Judith comes back from England, they plan a very good grand dinner with lobsters and champagne, and they welcome Judith back. And suddenly Richard starts crying at the table. Now John, who is 15 years old, is the second youngest son. And he is wondering why Richard is crying, and he asks his mother why father is crying. And Joan tells the boy about their separation. And the youngest Margaret, who is only 13 years old, she says that, I knew that you people are going to get separated because I had this feeling for a long time and my fear has now become true. And John demands to know why they wanted to get separated. And Richard tries to explain to him, even though he is very young, that they do not love each other anymore, and so they decided it's better to they go in their own way than to live together without any love. And to explain to him further, after dinner Richard takes John and they go for a walk. And at that time John says that everything is frustrating for him. That is, he's joined in a new school and he's not able to get along with others there, and he's not very happy. And at home also, now he's come to know that his parents are going to get separated. And at that time, Richard says that if you're not very happy with the school, it is better you change the school. And he says that I'll definitely transfer you to a new school and there you will be happy, don't worry. And he tells him that he can always confide anything to him and he's there to help him out. And then when he comes back, Joan calls Richard and she asks him why he cried at the table. Because when he cried, it appeared as though it was Joan who had this idea of separation, and it was Joan who wanted the divorce, and it was Joan who thought that they'll be happy if they are separated. And Richard also feels very bad about crying at the table. And now they sit and talk because they have informed three of the children. And the second older son, Dicky, has gone for a rock concert. And this Dicky is a 17-year-old boy, and they feel that they have to inform him also. They have not informed him yet. And as they talk, they decide that it should be Richard who is going to tell this about this matter about separation to Dicky, because Richard and Dicky are almost the same. They think alike and they behave the same manner. So Joan says, it's better you tell him because you will know how to tell him and he will also receive it in a better way from you. So what happens is, on the day when Dicky is coming back, Richard goes to the railway station to pick him up. And that time only he realizes how much he is scared to reveal the news of the separation to Dicky. But anyway, before reaching home, he tells the news. And Dicky is of course stunned to hear that news because he never expected his parents will get separated. But he just takes his stockily and they come back. And as they are coming back, they cross a house, and Richard tells Dicky that he hopes to marry a woman who is in that house one day. And when they come home, Dicky just goes to his room without talking to anyone. So in the night, Joan and Richard, they go to call him for dinner. And when he says he is not in a mood to have food, they say good night. And Joan goes away. And Richard goes near Dicky and he gives him a good night kiss. And Dicky returns a kiss. And this time, Dicky kisses his father in his lips. And that was the time when Richard realizes that his kiss was as passionate as a woman. And then Dicky asks with agony to his father why they are getting separated. And when Dicky is asking only, Richard realizes that he has even forgotten the reason for what he wanted a separation from his wife. Because the real reason is not that they do not love each other, but he has forgotten why he wanted the separation, and the story ends here. It's a beautiful story. If you have anything more to add on to this, please write it in the comment box. Like the video. share it with your friends. And if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. And while subscribing, don't forget to press the bell button. Only then you will get the notification of all my videos when I post them. Thank you.